How are we doing today? We're back here at the workbench. We're going to try and get this finished up today. I want to wish everybody a happy Easter. And I know that right now it's kind of difficult times for a lot of people. Can't be with all their family. Hopefully everything works out for all of you. Everybody stays healthy. But we're going to get started here. We're back at the workbench. We've got this whole, it's a Walbro carburetor off of this home light. This is going to be, I think, part three. Hopefully today we'll get this thing wrapped up and we'll show it starting and running and maybe even cutting some wood this afternoon. We're going to rebuild this carburetor. I've got my carburetor kit here. This is a Walbro carburetor. Some of these carburetors on these home lights will say, some of them are Tillison. Some of them are, a lot of them are Walbro. Some of them are Zamas. Some of the carburetors on these are, they'll say Home Light on them, but they're actually a Walbro carburetor. For whatever it's worth, this is a Walbro WT, I believe. Or I'm sorry, HDC. As you can see here, I got a Walbro HDC carburetor kit. The carburetor kits aren't very expensive. A lot of people they're afraid to put them in. There's no fear. These are very simple carburetors to work on. I would steer away from using the Chinese carburetor kits. I've had a couple of them fail on me. Again, the main reason we have to rebuild these so often is because of the fuel we're using. And if you haven't heard, most all states now have 10% ethanol in all their gasoline. There are a few exceptions. There's off-road gasoline, there's ethanol-free gasoline, and there's aviation fuel. If you can get aviation fuel, that's probably the best. Aviation fuel has a very, very long shelf life, and there's zero ethanol in it. But we can't always get that, so try to buy ethanol free. I know that the stuff you buy at the gas pump is a lot cheaper than buying out of a gallon can or a quart can. But a lot of gas stations, I think Country Mart gas station has ethanol free. Look around, get on the internet, save yourself some headache with these. I mean, my personal Sols, I leave fuel on them year round. I don't have carburetor issues, but I don't use ethanol fuel in my carburetors. Our race bikes, we don't use ethanol fuel in them. We don't have carburetor issues. They have fuel in them year-round. But we're buying race fuel that's ethanol-free. So, today, we're going to rebuild this carburetor. Looking at this carburetor, it's pretty straightforward. Our kit comes with everything we need. This kit for the HDC carburetor on the little home lights is a K10 HDC. We're going to dive in. We'll go ahead and take this apart.
Kits Brooks here to tell you that running your business is a 24/7, 365 job. Every problem and every
inside of here, but when a problem arises and you need a solution, you're going to have a gasket and you're going to have a flapper pump. We want to peel this off. Try to get them off in one piece if you can. Sometimes if you soak them a little bit in mineral spirits, it helps. Just gently scrape off any of this black residue left from the gasket. Just be careful not to scratch your aluminum up. These carburetors are all made out of aluminum. And this is your sealing surface. So if you have imperfections in this or the gasket doesn't seal, the Sol may not run or run right.
Oops.
The Sol we're building today is actually for one of my sons. We cut quite a bit of firewood. he's at the age now where he's ready to start helping me cut. I think this would be a great little saw for him to start with. We're going to do some stuff on some other saws. We're going to play with them a little bit in upcoming videos. This is a new YouTube channel, so if you guys like what we're doing here, comment, tell me what you'd like to see or what you don't like, and we'll see if we can accommodate everybody. So I've got this clean. Inside of here, there's a screen. This is a filter to keep stuff off of your needle. We're going to pull that screen out because your kit's going to come with a new screen. Should come with a new screen. We're going to flip it over. We're going to pull out this needle. Look at it to make sure it's not damaged. Looks good. Those tend to get damaged if people try to screw them in too tight. If they screw them in too tight, because trying to adjust the carburetor, it will damage the very tip of this, and that's a very fine taper on that tip. This saw, as many of you, if you've watched the previous videos, was found in a garage. A lady found it. She didn't know what she had. She just knew that it was junk, or she thought it was junk. Wanted to get rid of it. So we bought it. I gave a little of nothing for it. Again, try to take these gaskets off in one piece. This one here stuck really well. When I put these together, I like to put a little bit of grease on this sealing surface. That way, if we do have to take one back apart, you know, next year, or for somebody else, the next person won't have to fight with getting these gaskets off. The grease kind of acts as a like Pam for cooking spray. This one's really stuck on here too. We have to get all this black gasket off here because it won't seal with this on here. The new gasket won't seal up against this. You never want to use a silicone or a Permatex. You should know, or if you don't know, gasoline will attack that. There are some better products out there than Permatex. I like to use Yamabond. We got turned onto that several years ago, racing bikes. Yamabond is actually, I believe it's not made by Yamaha. I believe it's made by 3-Bond. In fact, I'm fairly certain it's 3-Bond. It's a very good product. You can seal your case halves up with it. And in fact, that's what Yamaha uses to seal their cases up. This thing's really on here. Try a little solvent here and see if that won't help us. I like to use brake clean versus carburetor cleaner. Carburetor cleaner is a little more expensive. Brake clean does a great job. Carburetor cleaner, I believe, has an acid in it. With these small carburetors, you really don't need to soak them for long periods of time in like a gallon of carburetor cleaner or 5 gallons of carburetor cleaner. Sometimes I'll drop them in the wash, the parts washer, let them soak for a few minutes just to get the crud off the outside. That's what I did to this one. They clean up pretty nice. We'll probably edit a lot of this out. And I apologize if we don't. But try to keep these videos under 20 minutes. I know people have a tendency to get bored, as do I. You guys see or think of something you'd want to see in these videos, small engines, especially chainsaws, different modifications you can do, ideas, feel free to reach out to me. This is really tough to do without scratching this aluminum. I like to use these X-Acto knives because the blades are relatively inexpensive. You can get into the real small nooks and crannies with them. Get a piece of Scotch-Brite pad, and we'll see if we can't get the rest of that off the Scotch-Brite pad. Okay, I think what we're going to do is we're going to get to a stopping point and we'll start another video. I'm finishing this carburetor up. We're almost at the 20 minute mark, I do believe. I apologize. We're still working out some of the bugs and editing. This is all new to us. We'll go ahead and stop this here. I've got all of that off. I'll clean the rest of it off. I got 99% of it off there. I'll clean the rest of this black off with some residue and a Scotch-Brite pad off camera. Then we'll start a second video of the assembly of the carburetor, and we'll get the carburetor put back on the saw. We'll see if we can't get the saw assembled. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in a few minutes.